We want to introduce ourselves. I'm Em.
And their roommates, these are all our seniors, and we have one more though!
Mr.
I never chose to be the ocean. I never meant to crash upon every shore, rip through ships, tsunami my way through life. But they call me Marina, and so I am the crier of storms, the bringer of seas, the singing siren on the rock. I am a wild ocean, a teary and emotional Marina. You swirled me like a whirlpool and told me to remain still. You polluted me, and I cannot any longer be a vast blue mirror. Subsequently, you will be dragged out like driftwood. If you ever try to hurt me again, remember this. I am the ocean. I own every drop of water on this earth. So if you think you can try and lessen my waves or make me evaporate for your sake, your home will be Atlantis, and your last word uttered into dry air will be Marina. Scene.
Scene.
From E to EA.
From E to EA.
Anybody want any CDs?
Excuse me, sir, you can't be selling those down here.
Yeah, what are you
it is a law. You cannot sell CDs like that around here. We have told you several times.
Fuck off! Yo, anybody wants
What did I just fucking tell you?
What are you doing, man? Stop! Stop! I can't... Stop! I can't breathe! I can't breathe!
We need backup in East 200 Bay, right fucking now!
My name is Eric Garner. I died July 17th, 2014. And I died July 18th, 2014. And I died July 19th, 2014, July 20th, 2014, and July 21st, 2014. More days than I can count. More days than my mother can count. More days than my wife can count. Because everyone kept sharing my death again and again and again. And I would love to tell everybody that I was lived on, but I wasn't. Because December 30th, 2017, my daughter Erica died. And you shared it again and again and again. Do you know what it feels like to lose both a husband and a wife to the same people? A son and a granddaughter? Stop sharing that shit. Scene.
Scene.
When John gets too drunk, I go for a drive. When I start to think about death and question my own morality and Whenever I can't drink or smoke to forget something, I go for a drive. Because if I'm focused on the road, then I can't be focused on everything else, right? And I play the radio really loud, and I just drive. And then all of a sudden, I'm going 90 miles an hour on a 30 mile an hour road, and I remember that that's exactly the speed that Alyssa was going when she ran into a tree, and I wonder if it would be so bad if I ran into a tree. And then I start to wonder about what it would feel like, and then I start to wonder about what it felt like for her. Was she conscious? Did she feel the branches go through her body? Was she listening to music? She wasn't alone, and I don't know if that brings me solace or anxiety. Do you think she was scared, or do you think she just blacked out? Because I hope that she just blacked out, and I hope that she had no idea. I don't know if she went brain dead right away, or 3 days later. All I know is that 4 days later, she was dead. I go for drives when John doesn't understand. Because he's never had a friend die. He's never had anyone die. Maybe a dog once, but I have lost so many people. And I can't lose anymore.
Scene.
Scene! Scene!
Proclamation!
This is a proclamation!
Proclamation!
from outside the theater. I need to read this right this second, okay? I'm sorry for the delay, but... Okay, it's official. There are no straight white men in Red Theater. Mom, Dad, I'm bisexual.
Water bottle. I did not know he put it in my drink. It's okay. It's okay. Before you said it, I told you, don't fall in love with me. Don't say that, don't call me that, don't! And you always, always did. I told you to stop calling, and every time you did, it created caverns in my chest. My heart, with bat wings beating too fast, became a hibernating light. I did not know my heart without you, because you did not know yourself without my heart. And so I let my light die out, thinking that if I left you in the dark long enough, you might get used to it. Swim. You got used to it when I told you I was seeing someone else. Fall. The boy next door started following me back to my door. I got a no contact order against him the same week you started contacting me again. Flood. You sent me videos of my home. You sent packages to my school. And when you called me 27 times in 20 minutes because you thought I wasn't okay, I screamed that it wasn't okay, and you stopped calling, and started driving, and stopped answering. And then you carved my name into your chest and sent me a picture of it. You carved my name over your heart so the next person to break it would know that I did it first. Float, but you broke me first. And I told my mother, and I told your mother. And when she found out everything you did, she told you don't. Fly. And finally, as of late, you didn't. Scene.
Scene!
Hang my work on the fridge!
Hang my work on the fridge!
I have a depression! I got a 74 on my Shakespeare midterm! I want to hang it on the fridge! I'm really proud of myself because that class is hard!
Zero.
My best friend in the outpatient told me once that she would never eat any food over 200 calories because she thought it would make her fat. When I went home that day, I Googled list of anorexic safe foods under 200 calories. As it turns out, there are hundreds of blogs and websites written by people with eating disorders, dedicated to people with eating disorders, on how to teach them how to have correct eating disorders. If that's not fucked up, I don't know what is. I printed out the list anyways. Scene.
Stallone!
Depressed!
I think we're good though.
Depressed!
A list of things to live for. Tristan Stafford. M. Hampton. Peggy Stafford. The LIRR and how they announced Seaford extra loud. Walking through Forever 21. Free samples. Krista Rapping Kanye. My Tim's. Hiking rim to rim. R2-D2. Fresh blankets of snow. Kale salad. Puppy barks. Hiking rim to rim. R2-D2. Fresh blankets of snow. Jazz where you can hear the fuzz of the old recording. Kale salad. Puppy barks. Tristan Stafford. I'm Hampton. The office of Peggy Stafford. The LIRR and how they announced Seaford. Extra loud. Peggy Stafford and how they announced Seaford. Extra loud. Fresh blankets of snow. Kale salad. Puppy barks. Kale salad. Puppy barks. Kale salad. Puppy barks. That's right, you can hear the buzz of the old recording. Tristan Stafford, I'm into the office. Peggy Stafford, the LIR, and how they announced Seaford extra loud. They're free, walking through Forever 21. Free samples, Chris rapping Kanye, my Tim's hiking rim to rim. R2-D2, red blanket, just now cancel all the puppy price inside you.
Let's go.
play.
G.
Okay? Yeah.
A.
Okay. You in the back.
E.
Okay, yeah.
S.
That's a good one. Yeah, yes.
D.
No. First one. Oh. Yeah, over here. You.
H.
Z. Yo, that wasn't even a good try. you in the back.
M.
Yeah?
W.
The doctor say almost won. C.
Z!
Misogyny, or the song of my life.
Misogyny, or the song of my life.
Misogyny, misogyny, misogyny,
misogyny,
or the song of my life.
Go.
She's pretty hot. She's pretty hot. She's pretty hot.
You look good today.
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 What a cunt.
You look good today.
What a cunt.
You look good today.
Just
what a cunt.
You look good today.
What a cunt.
Just
breathe.
What a cunt. You look good today.
Just
you look good today.
Breathe.
What a cunt.
You look good today.
Just
what a cunt.
Breathe.
Let me get that for you.
Just
let me get that for you.
What a
cunt.
Just
what a cunt.
Breathe.
You look good today. Let me get that for you.
Just
you look good today.
Let me get that for you. What a cunt.
You look good today.
Just
let me get that for you.
You look good today.
Breathe.
Just breathe.
Sad boy, fuck boy!
Sad boy, fuck boy!
Sad boy, fuck boy!
Hi, my name is Steve.
Hi, Steve. Hi, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Hello, and I'm a sad boy fuck boy. Hey, you all know me. But this is Becky. She likes to do makeup tutorials. Anyway, I just got my first match on Tinder! Woo! So, I already know what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna mix some artsy shit with a little bit of emotion so that way I can come off as pseudo-deep. So when she asks what I do, I'm gonna say, yeah, I played a xylophone. Like, my parents were like separated, and that caused like me a lot of pain. So I like to think that I'm the xylophone. Like the sticks of our parents. When I get the xylophone, like the music that's coming out of the xylophone is me. Because that pain my parents had was like the music they made, and I'm that music. Week number two. This is the part where you're all wondering, am I listening to what she has to say to me?
Are you?
No! Because I'm a misogynist! Now, if I were black, this would be highly noticeable. But since I'm white, I can be mediocre and get a pass. So, when she asks me or tells me about her day, I just say, yeah, no, I totally get that. I grew up just like that. I completely understand where you're coming from. And I just really do hope that we can get through this together, you know? Because that's what it's about. Week number three! And I know what you're thinking. Really? Cardboard? But I'd like to have you know that I go to Purchase College and I'm environmentally woke because cardboard is so bad. But on this date, we only kissed. We just kissed. Nigga! I wanted more! Yes, I know that I'm white, but I go to Purchase College. I identify with the struggle. Week number four! We had sex. I stopped applying. She said, but I don't care, because it doesn't matter. Nothing matters. And ultimately, there's gonna be another girl who's gonna hear that story about that xylophone. Because I am the fuckboy. And not just the fuckboy, I am the sad boy fuckboy. See.
This is my nighttime skincare routine. All the products I'm going to be using are all natural and cruelty-free because who doesn't love furry little animals, right? Okay, first, I use an oil-based cleanser to remove all my makeup from the day. There's a lot to get off because I need a lot of makeup to look like a normal human being. Next, I'll use a water-based cleanser to make sure my skin is doubly clean. Sometimes after a long day of work, I can feel really dirty. I mean, my skin can feel really dirty. And sometimes if things are getting to me, like the wage gap or the fact that multiple men told me to smile, I'll use an exfoliator to scrub away any of my remaining dignity. Next, I'll put some toner on a cotton round and wipe it all over my face. It helps remove excess oils and prevents acne. Lord knows I get a lot of that, especially around that time of the month. Next is my favorite stuff. Serum. I don't know like exactly what they do, but they're supposed to target different issues your skin has, like hyperpigmentation or wrinkles, because if people can tell you're over 35, your life is over. Serums are super expensive, so I usually just use them when I want to feel bougie. It helps that I get 17 more cents in black women and 24 more cents in Hispanic women per dollar. Another thing I like to do to pamper myself is use a face mask. They kind of make you look like Buffalo Bill, but looking like a misogynistic serial killer can give you insight into the minds of white men. Halfway to 40, it's time to start preparing, ladies. If you think men don't take you seriously now, just wait until they don't want to fuck you either. And finally, a moisturizer, because hydration is important or something. Well, I'm getting tired. I need to get my beauty sleep. I hate my life. See?
Congratulations, it's a girl.
Congratulations, it's a girl!
Little unsteady, little unsteady. time to talk about what happened, to talk to a professional, and work on trying to move past this. So I told you what happened and how I've been unable to trust anyone in a romantic or sexual way ever since.
How is that any different from you being unable to trust your friends after they abandoned you in high school?
Well,
you've had trouble trusting people and being vulnerable. I don't think it's because of this.
It's a different kind of trust. I think this affected it. I told you what happened in excruciating detail. You asked me explicit questions and I answered them even though it was painful to do so. I told you how drunk I was, how high I was, exactly where his hands were, the number of times I had to say no.
Well, that's definitely sexual harassment. That sucks.
Unwanted sexual contact is sexual assault. Sexual contact where one party is unable to consent is sexual assault.
You could join the Victim Survivors Advocates group, but technically you're not a survivor.
What the fuck? What does that even mean? Yes, I am not a survivor of rape, and every day I thank him that after saying no 15 or so times, he finally decided to listen. But I spent 3 years believing that because it wasn't rape, it wasn't valid. It took a hashtag for me to admit to myself that I'd been sexually assaulted, and another 3 months for me to tell anyone. It is your job to help people, to give them a shoulder to lean on, to teach them how to help themselves. And in less than 20 minutes, you managed to minimize my experience, minimize my pain, minimize the effect it has had on me.
Technically, you're not a survivor.
And essentially tell me it doesn't matter. So fuck you, Shahnaz Mudad. Fuck your technically. Fuck your antiquated ideas about what other people can do to my body. Fuck you, because I'm here. I'm surviving. Yes. I'm a survivor. Yes.
This is for the time.
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 While telling me about his son in the Marines. This is for the time my gym teacher teaches me while putting his whole hands over my body. This is for the time my dad's friend stares at me in a way I don't ever want to be seen. This is for the time he weighs my breasts like they are fruit he's buying in the market. The time. And this is for the time you hold my waist. And this time I don't flinch, but you're the one who runs away.
Friends.
Aww.
And co-directors of Red Theater Burgess, which is also
where we met.
Crazy.
This is Kara's last year and last show with me, which is really sad because we're BFFs. So we decided to do something crazy.
Crazy!
What are we doing, Kara?
We're gonna get matching tattoos right here, right now, and you're gonna pick it. Sort of. Okay, well, you ruined it, but it's fine.
Okay,
it's fine. It's supposed to be exciting and thrilling.
Yes, it is. Okay, so here's the thing. It's Kara's last show and my first tattoo ever in my entire life. So you can tell I'm terrified, but it's exciting.
It's gonna be crazy.
It's great.
So you have three options.
Yes. What is the first? This is the first option. What is it, Kara?
A triangle.
Ooh. What does that stand for, Kara?
The triangle stands for a mountain because we're climbing it and we're doing good. Yeah.
The next one is this question mark.
A question mark.
Why?
Funny you ask. A question mark stands for a piece that Em and I did together. And we said, I'm fine. A lot.
It's a punctuation piece, like the one you saw earlier.
Which is like this.
Yes.
But it is a reminder that we are doing fine and we can always ask each other for help.
Wow.
Crazy.
Ooh. The last option is
dot, dot, dot.
What does this mean?
That means that our sentence goes on.
Forever.
RTP!
Red Theater Purchase!
Kara and Em!
But yeah, so these are your options. What's gonna happen is we're gonna say them again, and you're gonna woo for the one that you want. The loudest woo is the one we're gonna get.
We're not gonna sit here for the whole tattoo. We're gonna sit over there and get our tattoos done. Someone's literally putting on gloves already. We'll call Scene and come on up here and go, Scene, when the tattoo is done.
So, tattoo artist, will you raise your hand, tattoo artist? Mariah and Sean, thanks.
Yeah. You guys can head on over there, so we're gonna vote if you would like a triangle.
Say woo. Woo. If you want a question mark, say woo.
Professional
See?
Massive beer gut, a lot of excess flab, a double chin, crumbling metabolism, and the genetic history of every person in my family who's eaten their way past the 300-pound mark and flirted with heart disease.
And no one else sees that?
No, they just seem to see some tall, skinny guy. Yeah.
I don't think it's the mirror that's broken. Wow.
See?
Every single time that I rap, I'm not BSA, but I'm teaching how to act.